morning.
Thank you for being here. We're really excited to bring this car to you. About a year and a half ago in Detroit, our global CEO and president, Mr. Hachigo, promised that we would be bringing to the market a dedicated hybrid from North America, made in the United States. And today, this vehicle delivers on that promise. He also talked a lot in detail about our 2030 vision. That 2030 vision includes, or a really important part of that is, that about two-thirds of our entire fleet by sales volume will be electrified in one form or another. And this is one of the first steps in that direction. This insight is really fulfilling that commitment that he made about a year and a half ago. Looking back at Honda's history in electrification, we've got a legacy of pioneering achievements in, when it comes to electrification, starting with that first EV Plus in the mid-90s. Then, of course, first generation Insight, which was America's first hybrid vehicle. And following that, three full generations now of fuel cell, Clarity fuel cell vehicles, and other achievements along the way. All of that built a foundation of knowledge for us that enabled us to bring this car to market, this new Insight. Of course, we're excited that this is the latest evolution of our technology. It's our latest two-motor system with even more refinement and more functionality. When we first showed this car in Detroit, the prototype of this car at the Detroit Auto Show this January, we got a lot of good reaction, and more as we showed the production model in New York earlier this spring. And most of it's been really positive from the market and from many of you. But of course, we're entering the sedan segment and a pretty crowded hybrid segment. So there are a couple of headwinds that we've got to overcome. And I want to talk a little bit about that before we get into the details on this. Of course, this is the third electrified model in our lineup today, following the Accord hybrid that's been doing very well in the market, and our pinnacle product, the Clarity plug-in hybrid. And they're all different elements of our hybrid vehicle strategy. So we look at this as setting the foundation and really setting the stage for fulfilling that promise or that commitment of two-thirds electrified vehicles by 2030. And each one of these plays a slightly different role in the lineup. So the way we see the market building is right now people are just getting familiar with hybrid technology. We think full hybrid vehicles, or FHEVs as they're often called in the market, are really one of the foundational pieces of that, just to get people comfortable with the technology. So the transition from ICE will take a little bit of time, and people need to ease into it. A full HEV is sort of the easiest way to do that, because they don't have to do anything differently in terms of their behavior. They drive the car, they fill up the tank, and they keep going. They just happen to get better mileage. Plug-ins take a little bit more getting used to. People are still confused. You might have seen the advertisement we've had recently that explains how plug-in hybrids work. It's actually been one of our most popular ads when we track viewership. People are really interested in that, and they want to understand more about it. But the reason is that plug-ins are still a little bit unfamiliar to people. They're trying to understand, do I have to plug it in? Is it a hybrid? Is it a battery electric? What does it do? How do I have to use it? And we're trying to get people comfortable with that technology. That'll take a little bit more time. In the meantime, we expect that full HEVs will be more popular. Of course, this is building toward a future where we'll have a lot more battery electrics as capacity increases, as energy density improves, and charging time improves. But ultimately for us, our vision is that we would get people to transition to fuel cells, which is really the cleanest and ultimate technology in terms of electrified powertrains. Now, it doesn't hurt at all to introduce this car at a time when gas prices are steadily on the rise. And we'll get into fuel economy and some of the specs a little bit later on. But the truth is, without big jumps in big spikes in fuel prices, we don't see big behavioral change from these modest increases in fuel economy. So to introduce a hybrid that does well, we've got to offer a lot more than just really good fuel economy. The concept that we started with from the very beginning was to deliver a car that wasn't just about fuel economy, but was a great car with great performance, great features, great value. It has to be great looking, and it just happens to be a hybrid. So from the outset, we wanted universally appealing styling. We wanted uncompromised utility, good cargo space, and good seating comfort and everything else, premium features, and it just happens to be electrified. You might ask why a sedan in a market where Over two-thirds of the vehicles being sold right now are light trucks. And the truth is, the sedan business is really good. For us, this year is probably the first year that we'll sell slightly more than half of our fleet as light trucks. But we still see really good business and solid business in passenger cars. We wouldn't walk away from 750,000 customers that are coming to us each year to buy passenger cars. And this fits the customers' expectations. We still see good business here. In terms of positioning within our own lineup, of course, Insight takes the place of the entry level or the gateway model for electrification, slotting in just below the Accord Hybrid that's already in the market. And of course, the pinnacle of our electrified vehicle fleet right now is the Clarity plug-in hybrid. And finally, you might ask, why Insight instead of Civic Hybrid? Well, the truth is, this is really about positioning in the marketplace and buyer mindset. We wanted to have a vehicle that was a little bit more mature, a little bit more sophisticated, and fit a slightly different life stage than Civic. Civic has a connotation with younger buyers, a little bit less premium, more sporty. We wanted this to fit somebody who maybe has a slightly higher household income, could be in a different life stage, a little bit more settled, and to do that, we had to invest in making a vehicle that had a little bit more refinement, unique bodywork, and positioned slightly differently than the Civic. So that's why we chose to do that.